Hey everyone, in today's video we're going to be looking at the hyperbolic trig functions. More specifically, the main goal for this episode is to find closed form expressions for Cauchy inverse and Sinch inverse. In order to do this, we'll need to define the functions, show some necessary identities, and then get on with the proof. The timestamps for everything are on the screen and in the description. This won't be a motivated or intuitive introduction to these functions, but if you'd like that, let me know in the comments. As a quick reminder, we define cosh of x as e to the x plus e to the minus x over 2, and sinh of x as e to the x minus e to the minus x over 2. The first identity we need to prove is that cosh of x plus sinh of x equals e to the x. To prove this, we can just substitute our definitions of cosh and sinh. Remember that cosh of x is e to the x plus e to the minus x over 2, and sinh of x is e to the x minus e to the minus x over 2. Since both of these fractions have the same denominator 2, we can combine them. Notice that we have e to the x plus another e to the x. This gets us 2e to the x. We have a plus e to the minus x and a minus e to the minus x. These cancel out to give us 0. And of course, these 2s cancel out. And this is what we wanted to prove, so QED. The next identity might look a little bit more familiar. Cosh squared of x minus sinh squared of x equals 1. Now we could do this by just substituting our definitions, but we can also cheat a little bit. Since both of these terms are squared and are being subtracted from each other, we can use difference of squares to factor this. The first term is just going to be cosh plus sinh, and the second term is going to be cosh minus sinh. Now we already know that cosh plus sinh is e to the x, and in a very similar way, we can show that cosh minus sinh is e to the minus x. If we multiply these two through, we'll have e to the x minus x, which is just e to the 0, which is 1. And that's how we prove this identity. You may notice this is very similar to the Pythagorean identity that says cosine squared plus sine squared equals 1, but now, instead of a plus, it's a minus. Now we're going to go through the main proof of how to find closed form expressions of the hyperbolic inverses. We're going to show this for cosh of x, but for sinh of x, it's essentially the same. To start, we're going to define y as cosh inverse of x. Hopefully you'll see that this is equivalent to saying that x is cosh of y. The first thing we need to do is find sinh of y in terms of x, and to do that we're going to use the hyperbolic Pythagorean identity. Now remember, cosh of y is just equal to x, so cosh squared of y is just equal to x squared. Now, if we subtract the 1 and add the sinh squared, and then take the square root. Next, we're going to substitute our expression for sinh of y into the sum identity. So cosh of y is just x, and sinh of y is just plus or minus the square root of x squared minus 1, and this is equal to e to the y. We can then take the natural log of both sides, and the natural log and the e will cancel each other out, and we'll just get y. But remember, y is just cosh inverse of x. So now, cosh inverse of x is natural log of x plus or minus the square root of x squared minus 1. Going through nearly the same steps, we can find an expression for sinh inverse. Now if you're wondering why there's no plus or minus here, instead we just have a regular plus, think about where this square root comes from and consider the graph of cosh. Now you can also solve these just from definition by multiplying through to get a quadratic in terms of e to the y, but I think this way is much nicer. As a bonus question, find a closed expression for the inverse of the hyperbolic tangent. It's a bit different, but still quite easy. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe, and if you have any questions or spotted any mistakes, feel free to leave a comment. Cheers.